Have you heard of a powerful productivity method called Eat That Frog by Brian Tracy? Ever wondered why some people seem to tackle their biggest challenges head on while others procrastinate? This method teaches you to identify and conquer your most important tasks, also known as your frogs, first thing in the day. In this video, I'm excited to show you a template tour and tutorial of my Eat That Frog Task Manager Notion template inspired by Brian Tracy's book. It's designed to help you implement this methodology into your daily workflow, and it also includes worksheets to gain clarity and weekly and monthly reviews. If you find this video useful, be sure to like, subscribe, and turn on the notification bell. Let's dive right in. Let's first start with an overview of this template. So this Eat That Frog Task and Project Planner is designed primarily for task management and also to manage your projects. On the left-hand side, you'll have a quick action button for New Frog Worksheet. These worksheets are designed to provide clarity and go through some of the prompts that could help you determine your frogs of the day. If you're new to Eat That Frog, the frogs basically means the biggest, most ugliest task of the day that's also going to give you the highest value when you complete them. And those are usually the ones that are the most easiest to procrastinate on, which is why this methodology can be so useful. Underneath New Frog Worksheet, you can also add a task and you can also add a project. Underneath the quick action buttons, you can see today's frogs. You can set a today's goal. And in this case, we have 6 frog points. So what this means is that your biggest, most ugliest tasks has 3 frog task points here when you complete them. And then things that you should do, important but less urgent, are 2 points. And then 1 point for frog tasks, nice to do and no real consequences. So this kind of gamifies the task completion as well, which can be really fun to track how many frogs that you've completed that day. Underneath here, you can see the navigation. You have your daily check-in and check-out. There's projects and tasks, frog worksheet entries, weekly planning and reflection, and monthly planning and reflection. And underneath here, there's the databases, which I recommend not to delete, or the template might not work the way it's intended. Here, I've also added a Pomodoro timer so that you can use that to focus on those frog tasks as well. At the top here, you can see your current projects and also all the projects by status. And here we have our task list and a quick guide on how you can assign the frogs to your tasks. And the different tabs are today's incomplete, due date calendar, incomplete by when to do, and then a view all by status. So the first thing I would recommend doing when you get started with this template is to start a new frog worksheet. What this is a guided prompt system that can allow you to gain clarity if you're feeling overwhelmed, distracted, or you're just simply new to Eat That Frog. I think it's really useful to complete this worksheet. And if you're new to Eat That Frog method, it explains what they are. And once you finish this part, then you should have some ideas on what kinds of tasks that you've really been procrastinating on. So let's say that a 3 frog task is something like updating my resume, has something to do with a project, which is to start job search. Then you could add something like this, it has 3 frogs here. And maybe you've been putting this off for a really long time to update your resume. So adding them here makes a lot of sense. Then you can check your project. So you can see that you've just added the start job search here, and you can even go ahead and start planning that project or just by clicking this open and then adding tasks to it. So you can already see updating my resume is already here. And there's a bunch of questions here as well for project planning. If we go back, then the next step is going to be going over environment and distractions. And these also encompass some of the elements of Eat That Frog that's beyond the core methodology of completing the biggest task first thing in the day. But it also includes things like setting up your environment, thinking of your big picture goals that go beyond the Eat That Frog system. Once you're done with that worksheet, all the worksheets get saved in this page over here, Frog Worksheet Entries, and you can also mark it as complete when you're done and it's going to go to complete. So make sure to do this periodically, especially when you start feeling like you're procrastinating a lot and you're not sure what are the high value tasks that you've been putting off. Now if we return home, and the next thing I would recommend doing to get started with it is to go to your projects and tasks. So these are your current projects and also your status. Now that we added this through the worksheet, Start Job Search, it appears here. To walk you through what that looks like, you basically have dates that you can add. Let's say that I'm going to spend the whole next month doing this, then I can add the end date here and then do this. And then you can also add a life area. Let's say this is for your career. Once you feel like you're going to get started on it, you can put in progress to see, show up in the in progress section. Here you can add up all of the frogs that you've completed. So right now it's zero, as well as task completion. The next step you can do is list out all of the things that you need to do in order to move this project forward. And this can change as you go. You might add more things. So let's say that you need to gather references. And this is also a three frog task because it's kind of daunting to ask people for references. So gather five references. That could be another one. And you could add also smaller tasks as well here. Project planning section here is a guided prompt, like what's the outcome I want to achieve? Why does this project matter to me? What are some major tasks or milestones involved and so on? When you're done with the project, you can go ahead and do the project review, and that allows you to complete the project. Once you're done with this part, you can click out, and then as long as it's in progress, it's going to show up here, Start Job Search. You can also add a cover photo by going to Add Cover, Change Cover, and I recommend going to Unsplash, let's say Job Search, and add a new picture here. Once you have those projects, the next thing to look at would be your task list. There is a guided approach to this in the daily workflow, but to get started, you can just simply look at this here. So you can see your due date calendar, and these are things where you have hard deadlines that you set for yourself or from external sources that you really need to complete a task by. You can check here. And then we have incomplete by when to do. And this means that when you're actually planning to finish these tasks, whether that's today, tomorrow, this week, this month, or if you haven't put them into your list yet, then it's going to end up here. So these are from the Start Job Search project, gather five references, updating my resume. You can decide whether you're going to do it this month or this week, tomorrow or today, or just leave them in when to do for now. I would recommend keeping the three frog tasks one per day, or making sure that it's manageable in general. You can really make sure that you identify what is the number one task of that day. So for example, for this week, you could have maybe three frog tasks in the list, and then the rest can be two or one. And it's really important to delegate or eliminate whenever possible. So if you click one of these, you can see in progress, delegate, eliminate, or done. And this is also a part of the Eat That Frog method. Brian Tracy talks about this A, B, C, D, E method. And so the three frog is A, two frog is B, C is one frog task, and then D is delegate, E is eliminate. You can also click here to view all by status, and this allows you to not lose any task. So now we can click return home. Next, I wanted to go over the daily check-in and check-out. This allows you to really build this into your daily workflow. So here you can see your daily frog, set your frog points here for the day that you want to achieve, as well as the current projects that you're doing. The first thing would be to start your day. So you can start your day with a quick reflection by clicking plus new page, today's thoughts and reflections. And basically you can fill three prompts out, and this is just to stay manageable. So what's my number one frog of the day? And if we look at our list here, let's say that you really want to finish writing that about me section. You can even control and then copy this one, copy link, and then paste it in like this, just to mention it here. Then 1 to 3 tasks I want to complete. These can be other lower value tasks that you need to do as well. And then what is my intention or theme for today? So the next is a task list. You can decide what you want to accomplish and focus on the number one frog and avoid marking all of your tasks as three frog tasks. Save the three frogs for the most important tasks of the day. So you can start by moving the tomorrow tasks that apply to today. So if you're doing this correctly, every day you'll have an empty today list. You'll see the things that you want to accomplish tomorrow on the tomorrow list, and you move them into today with intention and knowing exactly what you want to do. So let's say that writing the about me section is really important to you today, as well as choose and purchase a domain name. And these are all for launching a portfolio website by July. You can also check the other sections as well if you have time, but this isn't strictly necessary as there's weekly and monthly reviews. And if I open up the task, there's also a few features here that are really important. And that is that you can write out your consequences if you don't finish this task, as well as positive outcomes, just so that you can really stay motivated. This is only if you need that extra motivation. And if you need to, you can also write all sorts of things inside here, whether that's notes or links or anything you want inside of that task page, you can add them inside. Once you have everything in the today list, you can work from your homepage here for the task list. So you can see about me section, choose and purchase a domain name is in today. And if I go to today's incomplete, it shows me exactly what I need to do for the day. And one thing you might need to do throughout the day as well is to add quick tasks. So let's say that something comes up in your head that you need to do, which is to write your cover letter. And let's say that you're not even sure what frog level it is, when you're gonna do it or anything. You just put a task in here and you click out. And that's going to get added to, let's say here, you'll see in the know when to do the write cover letter. You'll also see it in the view all by status, a not started here. Some other things you might need to do is add a project. So here, if you just click add project, it gets added here. So you can see there's a new project. So now as you go throughout your day, and let's say that you managed to finish your about me section, then what we can do is to open this up and let's mark this as done. Once you've marked this as done, what's going to happen is that it's going to set a completion date and also award you 3 frog points like you see here. So in this way, it can keep you really motivated and compare your number to the frog points up here, which is your today's goal. It also shows you which projects these frog points are related to. Now, if we go back to our daily check-in, and let's say that we're ready to end the day. So if I open end your day, you can now add, what did I accomplish today? Did I eat my frogs? Why or why not? And what will I focus on tomorrow? And if you've already added one at the start of your day, then at the end of the day, you'll get the same thing here. And now we can check our task list again before signing off for the day. So try to clear out your today list by either moving them tomorrow, this week, or this month, or any task something you should delegate or eliminate. So it's important to move this today task to tomorrow so that you know that you're going to do this tomorrow. And you can also check your other list. So let's say that you added this write cover letter earlier today. You can now assign it the project that you need to do. So this is part of the start job search project. And let's say that you want to do it this month. And this is something that you're highly likely to procrastinate on. So we're going to put 3 frogs here. So now we have the write cover letter over here in this month, and today is clear. You can also check your due date calendar in case you're missing something. So now let's go and return home, and your today list should be completely cleared. The next important things are the weekly and monthly planning and reflection. So every week at the end of the week or before you start the next week, I would recommend going to this weekly planning and reflection and doing a overview of your projects, as well as doing some reflections and checking your task list. So here you can click into your projects, make sure everything's up to date and you have all of the tasks that you really want to do. And the next thing is going to be review and reflections. You can add a new one by clicking plus new, and what progress or wins did I make? What challenges or distractions got in the way? What are my 1 to 3 priorities for the next week? And you can answer them here and they're going to show up at the top. The task list below, there's a step-by-step process for this. First, you can check this week and make sure it's aligned with your upcoming week. It's recommended to clear tomorrow and today so you have a clean slate for the start of the week. So what I would recommend is to skip, in a sense, the end of the day for the end of the week. So on Fridays, at the end of your day, you can do the weekly planning and reflection instead. So the tomorrow task is just going to go to this week. And then you can think through your this month task list, what tasks you want to do this next coming week. So you're going to do write cover letter, research portfolio website, and maybe you're going to move these to this month like this. And then check your this month tasks. Are there any tasks you should move to this week? And you can move some more here if you need, like this. then check your know when to do list. If you have anything new here that you need to go through, you can do that as well. So now if I go return home, and then when you start your Monday, you can go back to your daily check-in, open start your day, do your reflection. And then this time today and tomorrow would be empty and all you would see is this week. So start by moving the tomorrow tasks that apply to today. That doesn't apply for the first day of the week. Check this week if there are any tasks that need to be done today. So let's say you want to make sure to write your cover letter and you're going to do the research portfolio website themes like this. And now if we return home, you can see today's tasks like this. So now what happens at the end of the month is that you go to monthly planning and reflection. You can again check your current projects, make sure everything's aligned. You can do your review and reflections by clicking new and then adding them in. Now if we go to the task list, I would make sure that today and tomorrow are clear. And just as an example, this could be what your task list could look like. So you would see a few maybe in this week that you didn't get done, a few in this month that you didn't get done either, and then a few that you don't know when you're going to do. So the most important thing is to categorize your when to do into this month. So just make sure that the things that go into this month are not things that you can eliminate. And you can also choose to plan your next week as well by adding some to this week. So now if we go back, the first day of the month, you would do your daily check-in, you would go do your reflection, and then you would see something like this. And again, you can move your tasks to today. Thank you for watching. Be sure to check the description if you're interested in this template. I'd also definitely recommend checking out Brian Tracy's book if you haven't already. It's a quick read packed with amazing insights that go beyond just task management. Let me know if you have any questions or comments, and I hope to see you all in the next video.